Let's bring out the teams. We'll start with the Rainbow Bites. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Starting with number 0, Amnesia. Number 125, Unholy Hand Grenade. Number 15, Scrambulicious. Number 17, Jesus Christ. Number 208, Small The Epidemic. Number 241, Pain Both Right. Number 27, Julia. Number 3, Ocarina of Time. 423, Fatality. Number 6, Smacky Kennedy. Number 626, Wikipedia. 76, King Doom Hearts. And number 9, Abraham Lincoln. Ladies and gentlemen, it's your Rainbow Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together and make some noise for your little Red Redditors! Skating tonight, number 13, Ramona Pounder. Number 1803, Helena Troy. Number 31, Bowling Murder. Number 429, Peaches and Scream. Number 43, Jill the Ripper. Number 51, Spirited Decay. Number 59, Dog Nothing. Number 80, Tempest Fugit. Number 89, Big Mac. Number 96, Pain Forest. And number 86, Sunny Delights. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the Little Red Riveters. All right. Well, we've already been through a quick one check. We're going to get this business started here in just a few short minutes. The officials are taking the track. The ladies will also be out there in just a second.
Can we take a few long minutes? NSOs and officiating crews setting up the track. The white boys in the middle. The girls have already taken to the pivot line.
Like they're going to be 208. Small Box, the Epidemic will be seen as the jammer for the Rainbow Bites.
And Tempest Fugit for the Little Red Riveters. And I'm sorry, they're not on the pivot line, they're on the jammer line.
That's right.
And they're off. Tempest Fugit looking for some sunshine on the inside line.
Small Box out there, about a small line as it glide on through. She's still stuck behind. Took a fugit though. Nice jammer action and awareness to slow it down.
But the fugit on the inside takes lead jammer for the Little Red Riveter.
Also breaching the pack. Small Box, the other unit did finally find their way out.
Red Riveter setting up shop in the backfield, waiting for some action, and Tempest Fugit jumps through, grabs her points, and calls it off.
As you know, in the game of roller derby, there are 5 players that take the track, and there's one of them that has a star on their helmet. That person with a star is the jammer. They are the ones that you score the points out there.
Keaton, how do they score those points?
Well, every time a jammer gets out and laps a pack, when they re-enter, every opposing player is a point.
As we'll see coming up shortly, we've got Gilda Ripper on the track for the Little Red Riveters, and she is right now the lead jammer.
And right now, it's a trap of work. It's still stuck in that pad. If you take it from heavy abuse, but did manage to get her way out.
Gilda Ripper coming up on the pack, working her way through, dropped to the outside and dragged way to the back. She'll be prevented from scoring any points while she's way back there. There's no one to pass, and she calls it off.
And it looks like there's going to be a late call right there at the end of that. There's a penalty on Travelations. She came in and hit someone below the knee. Now, penalties can be scored or can be assessed, and this is a low block. She hit someone below the knee.
So speaking of penalties, are there different kinds of penalties in Roller Derby King?
Yes, there are track penalties and hitting penalties.
Right now we're going to talk about the blockers. Those are all the other skaters on the track.
That's right, those blockers out there, they're responsible for playing offense and defense. Right now, he just finds himself front. He is trying to stop the defense from getting through that pass.
This is blockers from both teams right now. And that's Stephens Egypt breaking out, taking down 5 points from her pass.
Venus Bryant in the back right now, waiting for Venus Bryant to get through. They escort her out of bounds, in the apex.
Rainbow Bikes working really hard together as a group to slow down Tempest Bryant and stop her herself on her way through the pass to put up 4 points.
Maggie Kennedy doing a little bit of snappy out there on Tempest Bryant, trying to stop her.
Tempest Bryant breaks through, takes another 5 points. She gets 1 point for every skater that's on the track for the opposing team, plus a ghost point for any skater that's in the penalty box.
Edith Bikes really working over to the Fugit, trying to slow her down and not let her get any more points on the foul jam.
Rainbow Bikes making it hard for her to move forward, and we've got the Rainbow Bikes jammer back on the track. Strapalicious takes the inside line, and now she's back in play. Strapalicious stuck right on in there, and he's gone through it. And so the Fugit calls it off with Edith Bikes right on top of her.
As you can see, there are two players right now from the Little Red River sitting in that penalty box. And when they do go to that penalty box, they do have to serve 1 minute. You cannot field another player for those players that are in the penalty box. And they do still count as a point.
On the line for the Red Riveters right now, that's Gilda Ripper.
And the Wikipedia, they both engage the back of that pack. Wikipedia up front, trying to fight her way through. She's got 1 player left to beat.
Big Matt puts it to her on the line, but can't stop her.
Wikipedia is your lead getter.
All by herself on the track, Wikipedia slides through, takes her 5 points.
And that's a grand slam as all 5 players from both teams are on the track. Wikipedia up front right now, trying to get her way through. She takes some brutal hits, manages to get through, and that should be 5 points.
Gilda Ripper broke out, she's on her scoring pass, and puts on the pressure. That jam is off.
That was some really nice work there by Wikipedia, putting up a couple grand slams out there on the track.
The fans we would like to thank Ron Tonkin Fiat, Test Drive of Fiat at Ron Tonkin Fiat, and get free derby tickets.
Small box the other day, and Payne Ford taking a line with the stars on the helmets.
Full compliment on the track, and Payne Ford working over the inside right now, trying to find her way through. Drops to the out, one more to get by.
Tempest Fugit up front right now, trying to help out her jammer and get her jammer through.
Payne Forrest just driving Tempest Fugit that final blocker, making it possible for herself to get through.
Oh, we got a power jam. But small block epidemic did pick up a penalty on that pass, and a low block, she will be sitting in that penalty box for the next minute.
Tempted. Jesus, Sykes taking out hits left and right up front. Drops K-Force to the inside and drives her to the very back of the pack.
Now the player gets knocked out by the poison player. They do have to re-enter behind that player, and that's why she had to go straight way back.
High block called on Jesus Sykes, and she's on her way to the penalty box. Came forth on the track still all by herself. A little bit of that passive aggressive offense.
And a back block being called out there. Finally, K-Force takes away three. She does pick up 5 points on that pass.
Small Fox, the representative back on the track and up against that red wall in the back. K-Force drives the inside line with only one block and manages to jump in front of her.
Pivot, Fugit, hits up. Small Fox and takes her out of turn number one.
Fighting her time up front, K-Force breaks through, takes another five.
Nice job by Kane Forrest. They're going to have a little jammer battle out there on the track. Kane Forrest wisely calls that off as she knew that there was going to be points scored and that she not.
The fans, the hardest hit of the battle is brought to you by Bridgetown Chiropractic. Bridgetown Chiropractic, proud sponsor of your Road City Rollers. Thanks, Mike.
On the line for Little Red Riveters, that's Ramona Pounder. And Captain Strapalicious for the Rainbow Bites.
Rainbow Bites down to the penalty box right now.
Strapalicious trying to find her way through. Big Mac, though, comes up and wallops the big old Mac on her.
Multiplayer block called on Rainbow Bites, and they lose another one to the penalty box.
And a cut being called. She came in behind an entire back, or in front of, I should say.
Penalty box is going to be maxing out pretty soon with Jill Ripper taking a low block.
Strapalicious is your only jammer out there. Some fantastic blocking to open a hole, but a penalty being called.
Rotating blockers out of the penalty box right now. Strapalicious slides through, takes another five unopposed.
Well, this is how Jesus Christ celebrates Sunday. She goes out there and opens holes for her jammer.
Two on the outside, five more as the Rainbow Bites pulls up this lead.
Jesus Christ, another block on the outside, simply muscled the blocking wall out there to open it up to get that jammer through.
He's a side stop, just a little more of that passive aggressive offense. Mangles things just long enough to get a jammer through, and we've got a tie score right now.
And this time she calls it off. Picking up another 5 points, and we call the lead game.
A lot of amazing offense out there by the Rainbow Bites. Gave their jammer some relief. Fans, if you need debt relief, check it out. Kelly Brown, debt relief. Kelly Brown likes roller derby.
And so do we. It's going to be a timeout on the track.
Barely 10 minutes into the game. For the moment. And Tempest Fugit blasts the outside line and takes Lee Jenner right away.
And it's going to be a foot race to the back of the pack. So both players in the pack trying to get walled up and slow down that jump.
Little Red River is counting on that defense in the back to slow down that jumper. Simple Cupid grabs her points and calls it off. Well, fans, you can meet the future of car sharing. Sign up today at car2go.com. That's car2go, proud sponsor of the Road City Rollers.
Ball Fox, you have to bid it. So you've got a star on the board of Nebo Fred.
And Big Mac on the line for the Little Red Riveters. Powering that inside line. Look, good hit. Dropped it in the inside, drags to the ball back to the back.
Small Fox sitting down, but she's not in lead jammer. Big Mac is trying to call that off, and she did not want to have any more points racked up. It's their team.
Fans, check out the Open Safe Cafe brunch bar Wi-Fi. Embrace the pace at the Open Safe Cafe.
Once again, Vivid Zeke is taking a line for the Riveters.
And that's Rappalicious for your Rainbow Bikes. On the inside line, it's Rappalicious running away with lead jammer.
And Tim Achieve it right now, inside getting abused. Cannot find a way out quite yet.
Ooh! Some beautiful blocking by the Rainbow Bikes. Opens up the line again for Rappalicious, and she's flying through.
And we are in a power jam. That was a great move on that outside. This is stepped inside.
It's terribly familiar.
Nice. 5 points being picked up by Rappalicious on that pass.
Every time Rappalicious gets on the track, we end up in the same situation. Little Red River is doing a great job. He's cycling back up in front of her, trying to slow her down, but they can't do it.
You have to maintain a pack if you get too far out. The pack is broken and no pack will be called. You are, as a blocker, you have to report the pack.
Rainbow Bright again jumping in and clearing the line. The inside lane opens wide up.
Rappalicious going on a slowing frenzy right now. Finally gets taken out at turn number three.
Checker sees it back on the track. Rainbow Bright driving her all the way to the very back.
They were trying to take it back and slow down, but they are losing numbers out there on this track, and it made it real easy for Tempest Fugit to get through.
Rainbow Bright out there by herself, picks up a direction of play penalty and is on her way to the box.
4 points being picked up by both gamers on that last pass as the whistles start a blowing. Right now we've got a score of 74 to 43.
Well, fans, if you are in need of a home loan, check out Jessica Chestnut and Guild Home Loans. Let Derby Girl Jessica Chestnut help you get a home loan. So we're looking at an official timeout. The referees discuss what happened in that last jam.
Well, a lot of times they just want to make sure all the correct penalties have been assessed. They want to make sure that all the points are also right up there on the board.
Not getting enough attention, Mike. We got Big Mac on the line again for the Little Red Riveters.
And it's a Big Mac attack as Big Mac is your lead killer.
Well played, Steve.
With the Steelers out right behind her.
And up front, Big Mac jumps through, grabs her points.
That was a great move by Big Mac. She, all she had to do is pass to one player, and she got the two points extra for the players that are saving that penalty box. Mike Tech, what do you got?
I got a Rosebuds doubleheader happening in November. November 16th, all four home teams will be staying here at the hangar. Make sure to get your tickets in advance. Last Rosebud doubleheader we had sold out. That's November 16th.
Wow, Rockets moving to the front line. That's the old pivot line up there. And through Jill Larippa takes lead jammer for the Red Riveter. And small block of the Duke epidemic getting taken out of that corner. She's still sucked back in that pack. Numbers right now favoring the Little Red Riveter. Helen McCoy on the way to the penalty box for a forearm. With small fox, the epidemic, circulating a beating in the backfield. Spouses sometime on the inside line gets dropped by Pepper Sugit and picks up a track cut. This will be a power jam for Jill the Ripper.
Yeah, this is just the opportunity to live in her field right now.
Nice banging going up front. They're trying to keep the track nice and slow. But look for the offense when the jammer gets there, just like that.
Jill the Ripper through for another five. Jill the Ripper back on the line. Rainbow Bites moving forward with her. She breaks through on the inside and takes another five. This game starts to close up again.
It's a three-point game right now, Matt DeCone. And another sweepy hit. Angel Fight Price out there nicely takes her out on the outside apex.
Angel Fight seemingly everywhere on the track during this game. Right now on the inside and working her way back onto the track.
Glenn Reed, you want a little bit of that action out there, but Atlin, let it go.
Angel Fight with a gigantic hit, but a little bit in the wrong direction.
And that was a crushing blow. And Jill the Ripper still down, trying to catch her breath. Well, we've got a lead change. The Red Riveters, we're right back into this game, and they're up 2 points right now.
This is some seriously exciting business. That lead change brought to you by OHSU Sports Medicine. OHSU Sports Medicine is proud to be the official medical care team of the Rose City Rollers.
Jesus by taking a line for the Rainbow Bites.
And the big knock out front takes Lee Jammer for the Little Red Riveter.
And Jesus by trying to get out of that pack. And she is laying him down and put him down.
Big knock on the inside, grabs the points, she calls it off.
And that was orchestrated by her offense. They leave that wall out, gave her a nice easy line to run down and pick up those points. Point six.
We would like to thank Big Brothers Big Sisters Sports Buddies, the Rose City Rollers, is a proud Sports Buddies partner, encouraging young people to get active, especially on offense. Tempest Fugit on the line for the Red Riveter.
Fly pack again out there for the Riveter. There's one blocker for the Rainbow Bright in the penalty box. Sweeping hit to the in, or to the inside to open up that wall, and Tempest Fugit is out on the jammer.
Captain Seagate through, picks up her points and calls it off. Well, fans, if you need information regarding ticketing for upcoming hangar events, you can check that out at PortlandMercury.com. The foods, arts, and entertainment news you need. The Portland Mercury.
Well, with a score of 85 for the Riveters and 74 for the Rainbow Bites, the Rainbow Bites wanted to take a timeout and talk about what they're going to do to get back in this game and put that lead back up.
Back on the line for the Red Riveters. Big Mac.
Ball box is going to the back of that wall, trying to find their way through. Penalty being called, reverse direction looks like.
And ball box is off, she's going not to the kid.
Well, Big Mac managed to grab that coveted Liga Jenna title.
That's the second time Big Mac has done that.
Creeped out there, got knocked out.
Yes, that is true. Well, fans, we would like to thank Kind Bars. Not like there is a note tomorrow with Kind Snacks. I love those Kind Bars.
Those are great bars.
I can eat a bucket of those, man. Back on the line for the Red Rivers, that's Tempest Houston.
And Wicca, the whistle is blown. Wicca C has got the inside line, and she's your lead jammer. Tempest Houston out and burning down the safe agreement. Excellent work by the Rainbow Bites, setting that hole open on the inside for her. Well, both blockers got through there. Looks like it's going to be a 4-4 trade-off.
'78-'88 Little Red Rivers. Well, that insanely fast action on the track last jam brought to you by DerbaFit.com and Spark by Advocare. DerbaFit.com, Spark Rock, Recover, Repeat, Rose City Rollers, Independent Advocare Distributor. Back on the line, it's Big Mac pushing that line of three forward. Start the lift, she found the inside line, and she's your lead jammer.
Big Mac on the inside, she's on her swing pass. And the Rainbow Bites move forward to take the inside. Now, Slam Leisure got out there and opened up a hole wide for Strapalicious to jump right on through and get those easy points. 88-82, Little Red River is still up.
We would like to thank Joe's Burgers, four locations, awesome burgers, and official theater of the Rose City Rollers. Volunteers, that is Joe's Burgers.
And this game is on. Ocarina of Crime up for the Rainbow Bites. And Jill the Ripper for the Red Rivers takes Lee Devon.
Joe the Ripper, some great speed out there in the track, really making a way.
Whistles galore as Joe the Ripper blows through and takes all 5 points. Ocarina had a hard time trying to get through, they've got some great defense on her, but she finally finds it out of day, and she's out of that pass.
Joe the Ripper leads the way through. And get the points. And we would like to thank Shop Dreams, unique sector company shops for the poker girl and everyone. Check out their new Rose City Roller shops at Shop Dreams.
Seamlessly sliding from blocker to jammer, set the speaker on the line for the Little Red Rivers.
Both teams down one as Small Box the Epidemic is trying to find their way through.
Small Box sucked up. Oh, and she got knocked down in quarter number two.
She's a fight up front. Will Kimber front. They're off. Something secret to the inside as
Small Box is out and she could be jammer.
Something secret even in those moves. As to get past Jesus fights and Rainbow Fright again.
Jesus Fight and Angel Fright. Just a formidable blocking team out there. Really slowing down for the Jesus. Formal and a really amazing man.
They put that back out. They finally got to let her go. Because the Jesus is out.
Small Fox takes 4 on the line. And we're at a 1-point game in the bottom third of the first half.
And that was some great work by the offensive line to open up that hole, get her through, and she pulled it off perfectly timed.
Well, fans, when you are out and about, check out the Vita Cafe. Super tasty vegetarian and vegan food for thought at the Vita Cafe. Gilder Ripper back on the line for the Red Riveter.
Peaches of Cream trying to overhold the hole on the outside, and it is no good, but
Gilder Ripper is your lead demo.
Strapalicious is hung up there in that package. She finally got her way out.
Red Riveters working their magic, preventing. They go by from being able to stop Gilder Ripper. She drives through and takes all four.
Glad needs to try to slow down that jammer. Actually did a decent job slowing her down. It was enough to get her jammer back up in there and pick up 1 point on that pass.
Still a very tight game. And taking back to the line of former Red Riveters, Big Mac.
Rick Astuti out there with a star on her helmet. It's only a 4-point game. Though Red Riveters, though, the first of Bruce the century mark, sitting at 101, Real Bikes 97.
Both of these women have been having a super day out here on the track. Big Mac taking a beating and drops to the outside.
Rick Astuti once again finds a way to play on that inside. She's your lead jammer.
Big Mac drives all the way to the very, very back of the pack. With a studio slide through and takes all five.
He got around that track so fast that he surprised everybody as they seem to be looking right away.
And currently we have a lead change with some more points to put up on the board.
Should be 106 to 101. Rainbow Lights have taken the lead.
Well, as any of those blockers who play offense will tell you, the magic is in the hole. Voodoo Donuts, proud sponsor of the Rose City Rollers and the Wheels of Justice. Tempest Sneakit on the line for your Red Riveters.
Small Box also got a star on it. She's stuck behind a red wall right now. Out of trouble, trying to get through.
Great defense. Tempest Sneakit, your lead jammer. Small Box moving her way around the outside. Both on the speed, she's on a scoring pass.
And Tempest Sneakit on 1 foot, glides through. Picks up her 4 points and calls it off. No, it looks like it's 106 to 105 with 5 minutes left in this game.
Well, Derby fans, Black Cat Plumbing has been your local neighborhood plumbing company and a proud part of Rose City since 2009. That is Black Cat Plumbing. Payne Forrest on the line for the Red Riveters, already putting the pressure on.
And then legal procedure being called on Murder, she's on her way to the penalty box. And Payne Forrest, one player up the beat, back there, but it's Jesus Price, and Jesus Price doing a nice job working over that game.
Serapalicious. Jesus Price slashing open the holes in that red sea that was at corner.
Jesus Price did a lot of stuff out there. She did pick up that penalty. It looks like for a high block. But she opened up those holes and got more points on the board for her team.
Well, the Davis Law Office is a law firm specializing in employment law, civil rights law, to family and juvenile law. Check them out. That's the Davis Law Offices. Rainbow Bikes down 2 to the penalty box going into this jam with Tempest Nugent on the line.
Tempest Nugent right now pushing the wall up. She's got one player left to beat, nudges her off. She's your lead jammer.
With the studio on the run, she's on her strong pass as well.
She gets back to that wall, trying to muscle her way through. Man, she's staying bound, calls off as she glides it about, but she got her 4 points on this jam, and it's 110 to 109. Rainbow Bike still up by 1 point.
This game is very close.
That's right. We have got about 3 minutes till we get into halftime. And next quarter, you don't get much, folks.
I have a firm grasp of the obvious. This is a really amazing play.
So where's my Rainbow Bike fans out there?
And Big Mac pushes forward for the Little Red Riveters. Takes lead jammer.
Small box there, the epidemic, small hole, and could not get through.
Cut on the floor, put it in the penalty box.
And that was just a quick look for the wrong way, and she goes to Duco Clock right out of the sock, and she got passed on the inside line.
Great match, but sure grabs a couple of points, calls it off.
Open and secret mind, we are minutes away from halftime, so make sure you get those raffle tickets now. Those are $1 apiece, 10 for $5 is today's special, 100 tickets for $50.
All right, Little Riveter fans, it's 117 to 110, you are up. Where's my fans at, Little Riveter?
Kill the Ripper for Red Riveters, but it's Rappalicious taking lead together for the Rainbow Bites.
Rappalicious so far had an excellent day. And she picks up another 4 or 5 points on a grand slam. They just do not want to let this go. 117, 115 with a minute and 15 seconds left. No Karina of Crime out there with a star in front of it for the Rainbow Bites.
And that's Big Mac on the line for your Red Riveters. Big Mac driving on, drop to the out. And a multiplayer block being called on Rainbow, no, yes, on a Rainbow Bite.
And I'm doing that proud out there. She has worked her way around. She engaged the back of that pass. Top tip and a jump for a 5-point grand slam.
Big Mac continually dropped to the in or the out throughout this stand so far.
Oh, Marino. So fast. She's dropping that pack and she scored more points.
Big Mac drops in right behind her. And Jesus Christ calls again. We're at halftime. And we're just about right back.
Looks like the official hitting crew is ready. The singers are ready. The announcers are ready. What about you? Are we ready?
What are we doing?
Where are
we? Sally Hussey's ready.
Sally Hussey's trying to be ready.
She's in charge.
Well, once again, we're going to see you. We're going to see you. And Epidemic, a small box, the Epidemic out there.
Who stars on their helmet? And Jesus Christ. Changing her mind and coming back onto the track. Both teams down one to the penalty box, and it's small box on the side breakthrough on the outside.
Nice play on that outside to take small box out.
He's inside driving that blue line forward.
Both walls right now doing an effective job setting down the jammer, and as soon as I say that, small box in his epidemic finds a hole and she is through. And there's a new jammer.
Temple sees it with some fancy footwork. Jesus Christ couldn't quite stop the pass.
And up the middle line. Small box in the inning. Both gets up 4 points on that pass. That was a great call off. Knowing the other jammer was coming around. Right now we're going to score 129, 117. Rainbow Light.
4K now.
4K, yes.
Amazing Taqueria food with two locations on Mississippi and Hawthorne.
That's 4K.
On the line, that's Kill the Ripper.
And we're going to see ya. Good set down is on. Look at Tia trying to get through. She finds the hole. Big Mac could not stop her. She's the lead jammer.
Kill the Ripper held up for a second as Broken Out is on her scoring pass. Red Ribbon is currently down 2 to the penalty box.
Look at Tia, one player left to beat. She missed that one player, calls it off. And they have
Another 4 points on the board, 133-117.
We would like to thank McDonald Miller, McDonald Miller Facility Solutions, proud sponsor of the Rose City Rollers.
Taking the line for the Red Riveters once again, Memphis Ugent.
And off arena, the upside with the Star Rider helmet out there. She's trying to get her way through, finds the open lane, getting muscled around, but still managed to get through. She's a deep gamer.
Memphis Ugent filling up in the back. Rainbow Bite putting the suit to her, but she finally breaks out.
The nice blocking inside, and she's still trying to get through. She does hold off after being taken out. Nice defense by the Riveter to maintain that gamer and not let her soar.
Well, fans, we would like to thank Ron Honk and Fiat, Test Drive and Fiat, and Ron Honk and Fiat, and get three dirty tickets.
Oh, yeah. Big Mac on the line for the Red Riveter.
And she's out there with Jesus Spice. Competition of powerhouses.
Big Mac flying inside line trying to find some sunshine, but.
Yeah, Jesus Spice is out front. He's a lead jammer. There's a whole lot of hitting going on in that pack. Trying to get that jammer out.
Jesus Spice on the pack. Blows through and calls out the jam.
Excellent lateral movement there. She stepped one way and went the other. Got herself through 4 points.
OHSU Sports Medicine provides immediate care for Rosie Ruin athletes through their Sports Medicine Hotline. That's 503-494-4000. OHSU Sports Medicine.
Jill the Ripper on the line for Red Riveters.
And small box. Small box here that gets it. Jumped out there.
Jill has one blocker left to beat and still hung up.
So, Jemmer still clogged up in the pack, but Jill the Ripper way up front.
Small box here, but Jemmer got broken out of bounds. He has to start again. Jill cracks around there trying to find a way through and has got out on her initial pass.
Jill the Ripper on the line, breaking through. Excellent play by Tempest. She just cleared the way for her to break through. Saved her from the onslaught.
Well, fans, time snacks. They are a brand of all natural whole nut and fruit bars made from ingredients you can see and pronounce. Next time you're out, pick yourself up by a kind bar.
Jumping from blocker to jammer, that's Tempest Ugent for the Red Riveters.
All that after she just got done muscling around with Rogers out there, put the star on the helmet to keep right on going.
Stravalicious with the star for the Rainbow Bites. She's up the outside lane, and she's the lead jammer.
Tempest Ugent breaks out right behind her, and it's a race to the back of the pack.
Red Riveter is setting up shop in the front to control the pace of the pack right now.
Ooh. A nice big hit to get herself through. She did pick up, Tempest Ugent did pick up 4 points on that. Yeah, she came in like a monster and opened up that wall and got some points with a great speed.
Well, fans, we would like to thank Hammy's Pizza, Portland Vital Signs, Portland Independent Films, and Hayes Lounge, all proud sponsors of your Road City Rollers.
Love the kid's line.
Jill the Ripper back on the line. But
with Expedia out front, muscles her way through, and she's in lead jammer.
Red Riveter setting up shop in the front with only two blockers to work with, but one of them is Rainbow Bright.
Rainbow Bright out there just making mayhem in that pack.
I think everybody's looking at her instead of the jammer.
She's like a wrecking ball.
Well, fans, check out docbones.com, home of Bridgetown Chiropractic. Get adjusted and support roller derby with Bridgetown Chiropractic.
Yeah.
Grapple is with a star, but a Rainbow Bros doing the same thing, going right down the sideline, and she's the lead jammer.
Jesus Christ scored and kept the Jesus out of the back and slowing her down again.
Now, as I mentioned, these blockers have to play offense and defense at the same time. So when that jammer gets up, every time Jesus Christ runs back, it instantly goes into the offensive mode, busting up that wall.
Well, fans, if you need ticketing information for upcoming roller derby, like the 4x4 in December the 7th at the Coliseum, check out BoylanMercury.com.
That's how we're going to drag out for the Rainbow Knights. Big back cover her way through, but small box on the tail.
Small box pouring on the seam up front. Rainbow Knights.
Great jammer work by small box to force the call off.
The Rose City Rollers are proud sports betting partners encouraging young people to get active. That's Big Brothers, Big Sisters, sports betting.
Gilbert enough pain, a crime out there.
And that's Gilbert Ripper of the Red Riveters, with two more to get by the front end, Lee Jammer.
Ocarina still stuck in the back of that time, and she's got a lot of big hits coming down her from Dave Torres.
Gilda Ripper not afraid to get down to hits of her own on the way through the path.
Oh, trying to get the assist, and ends up taking the Jammer out.
Big double. At the apex,
and there's a pile up, and we are going to bring this to an end.
After we went back up, make no mistake about it, this is a full contact sport, and things will happen.
Always let you get up and brush off.
Well, they're going to discuss it. Looks like she did get a penalty call to the lower lock. She will be staying a minute in the penalty box.
And we're back on the line for the Red Riveters.
Big knock. Strapalicious came out there. She wanted to play a little derby, but unfortunately, the W sent back right here. The jammer already in the penalty box. She was really for the team.
That means this is a power jam for the Red Riveters.
Nice slow pass. Jesus Christ right now really slowing down. She's getting a little help from Christ.
Ramona Pounder on the way to the penalty box. We'll have a little bit of
excellent foul shots out there.
And Big Mac kicking the jammer.
Well, they're going to play a little bit of passive offense, it looks like. Let the jammer do the work. Big Mac trying to get through.
And that's Tango Fly picking up the reverse direction. Number two on the way to the penalty box.
Big Mac takes all five. It's about the hard way. Nope, in that straightaway, they're playing the passive offense.
He's fighting. First line of assault there, and Big Mac dropped to the out.
Ball blocked there for a minute, that served the time for the jammer that had gotten injured. She has weaseled her way right out through.
Smoke off the epidemic, proving to be one tough customer in this second half.
And so fast, Smallpox was getting away around that track. He ended up picking up 3 points on that pass.
Purely speculation here. Smallpox may be powered by DermaFit.com. Smart Rock, Recover, Repeat, Rosen Rollers, Independent Advocate Distributor.
That's DermaFit.com.
Well, with just under 20 minutes left in this game, it is a very close one. 13 points separate these two teams, 151, 138. Rainbow Bites up right now. Travelers is out, and she's in the game.
Tempest Music, no fear. Not afraid to kick out her own hit. And Travelers is throwing off that jam.
That was great heads-up play by Scrabble-Izzard to pay attention out there, knowing where the opposing jammer was. Mike Tattoo, yeah.
Hope Baraka, realtor, helping Portlanders buy and sell their dream house. Check out Hope Baraka.
Gil the Ripper for the Red Riveters.
And Small Buck, once again, taking the line for the Rainbow Bites. Yeah, one player up the feet, a swing and a miss. Jeez, you're the jammer.
Gil the Ripper still hung up in the very back. Working our way through the pass right now, but Jesus Sykes is up front trying to slow her down. And a roadblock is called on Smallpox. That leaves Gil the Ripper on the track all by herself.
Oh, she's taking some big hits. She just fights. Look at a big old wallop on her.
Rainbow Bites with a pretty serious wall up front with some crazy blows in there.
Robot being called out there. Bodies were all piled up. They've taken Gil the Ripper way back to turn number 4.
I can't imagine any more punishing line than Jesus Christ and Rainbow Bright right now.
They are the defensive wall to beat in this game right now. And a robot being called on Rainbow Bright.
Jesus Christ.
She's willing to do it all by herself. He escorted her out of bounds once again. And people are finally going to smack that out there. She's going to set the first throw. And they take her out of bounds once again. Excellent defense being played by the Rainbow Bites right now.
Rainbow Bites doing an excellent job driving the jammer back over and over. Plus recycling to the front when they need to. Smallpox, the epidemic right back on it, pushing that red line forward and blasting our way through.
And just like that, Smallpox is through, picks up 4 points. And Jesus Christ was in the river. That was a defensive stand, if I have ever seen one. They burned that power jam right down and got points after she re-entered that pass.
And what a move.
Team timeout being called by the Little Red Riveters. Let's kick it over to DJ Agent Meow for a match of Tony Music Minute.
Oh, a nice nice move. He just finds his lining up, looking to hit her, and Demon Steve just didn't want no part of it.
Picked up the shot and went back. The Demon finds Ava Bright back on the track. Block is a record.
He's got to let it go, and there's five more points. We're back to single digits between these teams.
Ramona Pounder in there, causing just enough energy to get things done.
Another 5 points on that pass. It's a two-point game separating these two. And we've got a lead game. Kendrick Steven out there right now showing her strength. Picked up another 5 points.
Direction of gameplay on Eager Spice. She'll be spending a minute in the penalty box. And that jam is off.
And another 4 points being picked up. Will Red Riveters have capitalized on that last power jam? The Soul right now, 167, 155.
The Red Riveters out front. The Fantasy League change brought to you by OHSU Sports Medicine. OHSU Sports Medicine is proud to be the official medical care team of the Rose City Royals.
So Appaloosa's on the track right now, finding some sunshine on the outside line. Lee Jenner, Rainbow Bounce.
Going back, escorted to the inside.
Will Red River do a nice job separating that pack. Will Rock be called on those Will Red Riveters. 5 points for Scrapalicious. Nice slow pack up front. Will Red River is taking the back, waiting for that jammer.
Three-point being picked up by the Rainbow Bright. It's up 4 points in it now. Well, fans, if you are enjoying this roadside at Derby Action, make sure you come back on November 16th. We're going to go ahead and here to hang with all four roadside home teams competing. Kevin Seager back on the line for the Red Riveters. And small box.
Kevin Seager stopped long enough to engage Jammer, the opposing jammer. Gets it slowed down enough.
Kevin Seager breaks out, takes Lee Jammer, and small box, the epidemic. Breaks out, she's on her shooting half.
Small box on the side of Latte, and she's trying to work her way around.
Some excellent coverage provided for Tampa Seager, but Jesus finds the sound of the front of the back.
And Jesus jumped out there, picked up 4 points, and calls it off as he gets that 4 point. 171, 163. Where's the Red River fans out there?
On the line for your Red Riveters, that's Big Mac. Big Mac pushing the inside line, but it's Scrapalicious on the outside, unopposed, taking Lee Jammer.
Big Mac taking some big smacks in there, but she finally gets through.
Excellent waterfall of hit after hit through the back there by the Rainbow Bites.
Some fancy footwork, hot giving a dunk. Scrapalicious is through, picks up 4 points, and calls it off. Neither team slowing down remotely. I have a feeling this team's gonna come down to a photo finish.
I'm trying to figure out what a photo finish in Derby would look like. Ahead by a nose.
And Ocarina, right now, trying to get her way through. She's the lead jammer.
Stephanie's trying to break out. She's a fight slowing her down.
That is the battle of the night. Tickets to Ugin need to fight. Really having it out, especially in the second half.
Ocarina of Time hits the pad. Takes a bit of a tumble. Takes 2 points there.
Ugin 5 laid down a smackdown on Tickets to Ugin on that one. It's now a 2-point game.
Fans, we would like to thank Joe's Burgers, 4 locations, awesome burgers, and official feeder of the Rose City Rollers Volunteers.
That's Joe's Burgers.
Jill the Ripper on the line for your Red Riveters.
Wikipedia in the back. He found the opening on the outside. King Jimmy Gammer.
Wikipedia loves the outside line. Jill the Ripper finally breaking out. She's on her scoring path.
And Wikipedia coming on the afterburners. What a mighty. She got through an outside and picks up 4 points.
We've got a lead, Dave. We're running the Black Band.
That's right now, Rainbow Lights 173, Little Red Riveters at 171. We are just under 10 minutes, and it's a 2-point game.
Tempest Ugin on the line,
and a small box. It seems to be the trainer for the top of the day. Small box went around the outside, she is through. And small box is the lead camera.
And it's Ugin, no pass, no help. He's not the lead gamer. She doesn't gain the back of that ball. She's trying to get through. And it's Ugin pushing that line forward. Breaks through, takes her point. Small box, the epidemic drop to the inside. Is now moving away through the pocket and takes hers.
And that was great work by the Rainbow Bikes to open up the hole and get her through. But now they've got to stop to the Ugin. And so far they are unsuccessful at even slowing her down.
Two for her, but here comes small fox. Lap after lap, it's the same business, and that jam is off.
And she picks up 3 points, calls it off, and we're a 1-point game once again. That was Junior Dirty. That was insane.
1 again, Jill the Ripper.
Wikipedia out there with a star on her helmet for the Rainbow Lights. And Glenn Eager getting called off the track for a penalty. And there's a low ball being called, but the speed is out there in a power jam.
Big Mac escorts it to the outside. And oh, it's a tie box on that power jam for just a moment, gives them a chance to get their bearings.
Well, Little Red River's got full complement of blockers. Wikipedia's got a work cut out for her. No bridge was laid down, and they are engaging her out of play.
Big Mac being called for an out of play block.
Two players in danger, way out of play. Wikipedia gets drilled it down, picks up 5 points on that pass.
Sonny G following the Big Mac to the penalty box.
Four points being picked up on that last pass. Looks like the score got pushed up 194-179. Rainbow Bikes eking out a little bit of a lead all the way to 15 points now.
Jesus Sykes on the track unopposed. Red Riveters down to the box. Season fights, lead camera.
And once again, the offense from her team opened up that hole, held back those blockers just long enough.
Season fights, moving her way around that.
That's great lateral movement from that young jammer.
Gilda Ripper back on the track and engaging. He decides to blow through the pack.
5 easy points being picked up once again. And a backlog being called. So Kane Morris will be serving a minute in the penalty box for a backlog. 4 more points by Jesus Fies as she gets through. 208-179, Rainbow Bright 4 ahead with a 5.5 minutes left of this game. Slight half advantage right now for the Rainbow Bites. 2 blockers right now in the penalty box for the Riveters. Tempest season on the line for the Red Riveters, pushing forward. Goes to the inside line, and she takes 3 down. Small box trying to get out of that pass. Tempest season, though, calls it off. No points for your team. Fifth in the air for the Rucks.
Well, fans, that hardest hit of the afternoon brought to you by Bridgetown Chiropractic. Check them out at DocBones.com.
That's right, they can get a discount right now for going there. Be an emergency, you need them.
Both teams down, a pivot to the penalty box. And on the line, it's Gilda Ripper for the Red Riveters.
And just like that, small box breaks her way through. She's your lead jammer.
Gilda Ripper up against Jesus Fies, the front end. Can't quite find the sunshine. Coming around, it's small box on the inside line. She takes all 5.
Very, very nice work out there by small box. Right now, Gilda Ripper still hung up on the inside. Great duty laid down. Being led by Jesus Fies.
Right now, it's Jesus Fies running a clinic on the front end on how to slow down a jammer.
Nice hit on the outside, but a low
blocking hold. Yeah, right up until then. It was a low block, and she was on her way to the penalty box for that one.
Oh, okay. 2 players being called the low block. That's why it's interrupted. And just like that, 3 more points. This lead has been pushed up. 221, 179 with 2 minutes and 24 seconds. The Rainbow Bites did not want to let this team slip away. They have pushed out the accelerator and jumped out front.
Well, we've got an official timeout down on the track. We would like to thank Timothy Murray Photography. Visit TimothyMurrayPhotography.com for classic black and white film derby images. Our friend Timothy Murray is sitting down there in the corner right next to the Little Red Riveters bench. Howdy, Tim.
And timeout being called on the track. I want to review a few things. Have a little discussion about some stuff and things and make sure that all penalties are right, the score is right. Sears are ready to sleep. Make sure Pan Fedicoli's all right. I'm all right. I'm panicking. I ran out of fingernails if you are. So in this next jam, there will be 3 little different blockers out there as opposed to the 2 that are out there for Rainbow Bright. Both jammers will be on the track. With the CD, it looks like she's got the star on for the Rainbow Bites.
Well, remember, fans, this bout is for first place between these two teams. And if you enjoy that Junior Derby, be sure to come back November 16th here at the Hangar for a Rosebud doubleheader. All four home teams will be in action that afternoon.
Tempest Music leads the way through.
breaks out a big lead drummer. Andy Bob's waiting right now in the middle of that river. There's not enough players out there to try and slow it down. Only one blocker on the track. Two now for Biggest Music. Just barely her way through. One player left to beat. Smallpox up towards the outside and drags the ball back. Dave Forrest has got to take her way back and make a start again. Tempest Music on the attack, weaving her way through from the outside to the in. She gets the points. One more point. Now the Smallpox takes it. She does take up 4 points for her credit. Tempest Music back on it. She catches a piece of Pingo's right and drags her back in the pack. Dave Forrest opened up in just the first minute. Tempest Music could not release that pack with the hole. Pingo tries working over Tempest Music in the backfield. Small box moving away back into that pack. They're going to try and slow her down. They hit her in corner number two. One player left to beat. They've got to let her go. Another grand slam. Tempest unable to get past the apex right now with Tempest right on it. Smallpox here at the moment blows through for another five. And Smallpox put the hammer to nail the next game and sticks up another grand slam. Ottawa looks at the other way and they're trying to go to the team. Right, did not get taken though. She picked up Tempest Music and this game comes to an end. And that's the end of that. We'll win our official score. Rainbow Bites running up the score in that last jam. From Wentz Warden, that's the official score. 243-195, Rainbow Bites take the day. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise as they take their victory lap, the Painball Rainbow Bites. Plenty of time to show the love for both teams. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the Little Red Riveters! Coming up, MVP awards from the captains of both teams. The King in red pants and at the center of the track will run us through who the girls have nominated. All right, folks, just a few short seconds. I'll be joined with the captains from each team, and I'll be letting you know who the MVPs of these teams are. All right. So, who do we have as our MVP for the Rainbow Bites?
Eden Fly
is the MVP. And who do we have for the Riveters? If this is it, you're going to be the Riveters. Ladies and gentlemen, please, awesome players, a great round of applause for this game you got to see today. I'd like to thank Mike Jackson and Magic Pony coming out today to announce with me. And thank you, everybody, for coming down and rooting these girls on. Have a great day. Thank you very much.